So I'm here with Alan Robins, who is the Mayor of Brighton and Hove, and Louise Peskett, author of The Fearless and the Fabulous. And I know you've got some events coming up, some tours, to celebrate the women of Brighton and Hove. Maybe we'll start off with Louise first. Tell us all about it.
Yeah, it starts on this Saturday, the 19th, and another couple of Saturdays in July and August. And it's a brand new tour. I'm going to be looking at some of the really inspiring stories behind some of the women who have just been awarded blue plaques in the last few years. So they're really, really inspiring stories of pioneering women who have all made sacrifices, who have all done things that have put others first. And there's some just really great, interesting, exciting stories. So we're going to be walking around Brighton, starting from Montpellier Crescent and ending up in the Royal Pavilion Gardens.
Brilliant. And you're going to be, are you going to be part of the tour as well, Alan?
Or I should be. I'll be down in Pavilion Gardens, waiting for everyone to come back.
So Excellent, I
don't think my knees these days will allow me to do the walk, but I should definitely be there. On Saturday to greet people as they come in.
How do people get involved in this? Before we go into a bit more detail into the women, how do people... is it Eventbrite, I think?
It is, yeah. The event is on Eventbrite, and it's called The Women Behind the Plaques, Stories of Resilience and Bravery, but just Eventbrite, Women Behind the Plaques would get you there. And that's just how you book a ticket. Or if anybody wants any more information, then my website is historywomenbrighton.com, and they can get in touch with me if they want to ask any questions. I mean, it's a very, very easy walk, nice, gentle walk, about an hour and a half to an hour and three quarter, fully accessible. It'd be really pleasant. Quite a small group, so really nice atmosphere, I hope.
Tell us a bit more about the women then in Brighton and Hove, because I know we've got a big history of the suffragette movement, which has been commemorated before, hasn't it? I know there's a plaque near the clock tower, isn't it, that Lucas MP was there for.
That's right,
Tell us a bit more about the history.
Well, that's going to be a stopping point on the walk. In fact, there's going to be three suffragettes that I'm going to be talking about. I'm going to be stopping at the Quadrant, which used to be the WSPU offices, the Women's Social and Political Union offices. I'm going to be stopping at Minnie Turner's house, who ran a boarding house for suffragettes. And then in the Pavilion Gardens, I'm going to be talking about Mary Clark, who has a link with Brighton, who was the first suffragette to die for the cause, who has a very touching, interesting story. But there's also going to be Dr. Octavia Wilberforce, who was one of the very first female doctors in Brighton, Elizabeth Robins, who started out as an American actress, in fact, but she helped to fundraise for some of the women's hospitals in Brighton and Hove. Margaret Bondfield, who was the first female cabinet minister. Clementina Black as well, who was an important figure in the trade union movement and open doors for women in the workplace, and quite a few more, actually. There's loads of incredible
why
women
Brighton,
in Brighton's history.
Why is Brighton, and this is a question for both of you then, why do you think that we've produced these fantastic women in Brighton? What is it about there?
Well, I think Brighton...
We're a bit rebellious.
A little bit rebellious. We've always been a forward-looking city, and remain a forward-looking city, and hopefully that's why we can have tours like this, which promote the fantastic. And it's such a great educational tool as well. You know, if people see these blue plaques and they see Minnie Turner, who's Minnie Turner? What did she do? Go home and look it up. Elizabeth Robins, the wonderfully named Elizabeth Robins, who's no relation, as she's described as a towering intellect and a beauty of her age. I think I'm going to claim her anyway. And to learn about these people and to inspire young people, young women, into knowing that you can do what you like. And just one other thing to add, that all the money that for this goes to the mayor's charities, the five charities that we work with as the mayor's charities. So all the money will come back to the mayor's charities.
Brilliant. And what are those five mayor's charities? Have we got? I know Together Co is one of them.
Together Co, The Fringe, the Sussex Heart Foundation, Leo House at Home, and one more, which I shouldn't forget.
Off the Fence.
Of course, Off the Fence. My good friends are Off the Fence, which is a homeless charity working out of Portland Road, isn't it?
Brilliant. So I'm looking forward to this tour. We're going to be filming one of the tours as well. So brilliant. Louise and Alan, thanks for coming today. All the best. And
thank you.
Good luck with the book as well.
Thanks, Mark. Thank you.
Thanks.